Hey guys, it's a cold, snowy day here in Washington, D.C., so I thought what better time to talk about Aleister Crowley. First of all, I should start by apologizing for not uploading a video last week. I was a little bit under the weather, but I'm back now, and I thought this would be a great time to talk about a very controversial writer, the infamous Aleister Crowley. Crowley is known among occult circles as the wickedest man in the world. He is wildly divisive. He has many very ardent followers. He has many people who dismiss him as a charlatan and a self-promoter, and many people who consider him the devil incarnate. So we're going to talk about him in a little bit of an objective way here, as much as I am able to. I've read quite a bit of Crowley, and I recently read this collection of short stories called The Drug and Other Stories that I bought last time I was in London at a local bookstore. These are hard to find in America, but it was just sitting on a popular bookstore shelf in London, which was pretty cool. And I read that whole thing, and I wanted to talk about it because this is largely a literary channel, not a magic channel. So I want to talk about his literary merits. But first, let's talk a little bit about the man himself. He was, by all accounts, incredibly intelligent, very gifted, succeeded at pretty much everything he attempted to do. He was an accomplished mountain climber, highly educated, came from a wealthy family. He was a member of the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn, one of the early members of that. And when he got kicked out of that order for being terrible, he started his own orders, several of them, and eventually founded what's now known as Thelema, which is his own variety of magic, which has become something of a religion on its own and has a lot of devoted followers. He was also an incredibly manipulative, egotistical, cruel man in a lot of ways. He would use people for his own ends and largely discard them. You might even say he was something of a sociopath. He was a drug addict. He lacked impulse control in a lot of ways, although he was very disciplined in others. And so he seems to have been something of a paradox, someone who's capable of great brilliance and great insight and great learning, but who's also capable of behaving very foolishly and treating people very badly. So it's easy to see why there are people in both camps. I've read several of his books on magic, and I have to say, I've read a lot of books on magic, and I think he is one of the most clear, concise, easy to understand writers on that, and I think that he's come up with some brilliant insights, and his books are very, very valuable if you're interested in those kind of studies. So I have a lot of good things to say about him in that regard. But in terms of his short story writing, I have a little bit of a different opinion. Crowley was very anxious and very insecure to be considered a great and an important writer. He wanted to be considered one of the literary greats of his age. He wanted to go down in history as a fantastic writer of poetry, stories. He even wrote some novels, he wrote an autobiography, and he wanted to be taken seriously. He even told fellow Golden Dawn member W.B. Yeats, the famous Irish poet, that he was better than him as a poet, and they had a falling out over it, which is ridiculous. Crowley's nowhere near the heights of Yeats in terms of poetry. And then we come to his short stories. Now, I feel like this whole study, this whole collection is a study in trying too hard. He's desperate for his short stories to be taken seriously and to be regarded as important. And as so, they're very pretentious, they're turgid, they are hard to read. They're frankly pretty boring a lot of the time, which is surprising. You would think that a man like Crowley would be anything but boring, but I had a hard time getting through these. There's a couple of them that are quite good. And there's a couple of them that are, especially the early ones, that are based largely in occult symbolism. Drawing from the Kabbalah and things like that. And you really, they seem like complete nonsense unless you are educated in those areas and you kind of have a decoder ring to understand what's going on in those. And I thought those were somewhat valuable, a little bit moral teaching, a little bit of ethical teaching in describing how these magical philosophies work in allegory. I'm generally not a fan of allegory. I thought his most successful stories were those based on this kind of symbolism, but elsewhere, allegory can be very tedious, and I didn't like it very much. Crowley's writing is pretty stilted. It really comes across as someone who's desperately trying to be a good writer rather than just get their thoughts across. The stories in this collection come from a variety of sources, and they come from a long period of time, spanning the author's whole life. A lot of them are from his magazine, The Equinox, which dealt with magical matters. A lot of them we published anonymously, and a lot of them were published pseudonymously. He was fond of aliases. He was fond of disguising his name. He was fond of riddles and puzzles. There's a lot of puzzles in these stories. But again, it's more of an academic exercise than an enjoyable narrative to read. So, in summary, there's a lot to say about Crowley. There's a lot to say about his life and about his works. There's a lot of opinions you can have about him. You can be a devoted follower and you can be a harsh critic. I'm really neither. I try to take a more balanced view. I do think his writings on magic were, in many cases, brilliant. But as an author of literary fiction, as an author of short stories, as an author of novels, as an author of poetry, I think he leaves much to be desired, and I think there's much better authors out there. As I said before, W.B. Yeats was a member of the Golden Dawn. He wrote brilliant poetry. The Welsh horror writer Arthur Machen was a member. He was a wonderful writer of short stories and novels. I recommend these writers if you're interested in kind of esoteric fiction. They are much better than Aleister Crowley. So that's my review. I've been Logan Albright. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to try not to get buried under the snow, but I will see you next time.